Greetings to all, welcome to the channel Simtech05. In today's video, I will discuss on some advanced options for mass editing. Basically, if we have geometries, then we can edit the geometries, modify the geometries, and we can mesh surely. But this editing is regardless of geometry, whether you have geometry or not, it's not depend. What I mean? Orphan mesh, or we can say the mesh which don't have geometry, that also you can add it. Such options highly utilized by the industrial experts for the meshing, because many time it happens the complete assembly is not generated within the one system, it is generated within the multiple systems, and instead of importing the model with geometries, they import simply elements. Or it may possible the meshing is done in some different software than for the assembly and contact purpose, for the connection purpose that is imported in the hypermesh, and sometime you feel that you need to change something in the meshing. So one way is like you have to modify things again in the same software, or maybe with the geometry, then we have to call it again, then you have to assemble it again. That will be very lengthy. So for such purpose, we have those advanced options. We will see one by one. So first, let me assess only one component from the complete assembly. So just go here in the model browser, and here we have hide and show icon, and that is the isolate one. So I want to assess, or I want to use only the B pillar component. So I'm going to hide the other components. So this is my car body component. I'm going to utilize this options. Hide and show, just select this options. When you press mouse button 3, MB3, then this component will be hide, and if you press mouse button 1, then the component that available in this space will be show likewise. So I am going to hide this body component and going to keep this one component only. So instead of hiding or showing this component, I am utilizing the isolate options, and just click on that B pillar. So only the B pillar component will be visible, remaining all component will be hide. Okay, so here we have one hole, and we don't have here the geometry. Say this is my component. Say this one is my component, and we don't have any geometry for that component. Let us escape and hide the meshing. We don't have any geometry. So just show it again, and we want to modify some features like this whole feature. During the mesh generation, this region may not important for me, or I not realize that's importance, but now I realize its importance. It's going to be assembled somewhere, and high stresses are going to generate here. So what is suggested, if we have hole and high stresses are generated there, then we have to create some washer about it. If I try to generate washer using quick edit options, and here we have washer options, basically what we need here, we need the geometry, we need the lines, we are unable to create a washer. Some features for editing these holes or washers are also available in 2D page and quality index. Make sure you are in the quality cleanup. Just go here with the cleanup tool, and here we have some basic features for modification of holes and washer, but those also unable to add elements here. Okay, so what we can do with these options? Other options I already explained in my previous video. If you want, you can go with that, like smoothing element, splitting, dragging the tri elements. Likewise, say this element I want to drag somewhere else, so I can drag very easily. Of course, this modification will take little time, because here the complete assembly will be affect, or means we can say the contact and connection, everything will be affect when you change anything within the component. So those all options I already explained, please go with that video. Here I am trying to modify the hole or washer. Okay, sometime you may feel that hole size is little smaller or maybe little larger. So I want to change the dimension. And of course, we don't have here geometry, only elements are available with us. So go with this options, define the radial and click on the edit options. Make sure you define here exact value. Whatever the hole size I have for this particular hole I am talking, I want to reduce or increase that size. Say maybe I want the hole size of 10. So define here the value 10 and you simply click on any of the node of the hole. So I am going to click here. It will take a little time to update. As I told you, it is large assembly. Now this hole is updated with size of 10. Similarly, I can update any of the hole. Say here, I want to decrease the hole size from whatever its value, from its to 5. Say, look at, hole is updated. So in this way, you can modify hole's diameter. Now the second task is, if you want to add the washer near about the hole, how can you add? Look at this particular hole. So the options is not available here, even not in the main menu or in the bottom panel. That options is available in the utility. So here go with the utility and make sure you are in the geometry options. If you are on the user, then nothing will be visible. And you also have to make sure the user profile is hypermesh. So go to the geometry or mesh options. Then you have here one options. Add washer. I wanted to add the washer. So the most important thing that you have to define the hole nodes. So I am going to click on that, selecting one node and click on proceed, and the complete hole will be selected by the software, as well as center also defined by the software. So now how much number of layers you required? So these are basically number of elements within the washers. I want to define here at least 4 layer, and with the value of uniform or with the variable value, you can define the value or scale factor for the each. I am going to define here the uniform, and each scale factor should be 0.2 as compared to the original element size. One more thing I want to define, minimum instead of 6, I am going to define at least 16 element. And now click on add. And let's see the magic. Okay, hole is modified and washer is added near about the hole. Of course, few of the elements are not appropriate. So it happened many times. Go to the 2D page, quality index. Then go with this options, place node options, and switch them back. Now you may ask, those elements are failure element. As I defined 4 layer of the elements, then element size is reduced and those elements are failed due to the minimum size. Just go to the quality index and here the minimum size, say the minimum size we are getting around 1.1 and it is defined up to 2. So this quality is right now not problematic for us, because we define minimum element size intentionally, because I want to create here 4 washers or 4 element within the washers. Okay. So once you able to create the washer, let me move on the next. Sometime you also need to create a hole within the surface. But the problem is we don't have surface. So what we can do? Again, we can utilize here the other options, that is the trim hole. You may think, like, due to some reason, assume that surface is going to be assembled somewhere and you need here holes. Then go to those options, trim hole options. Again, it is asking for number of nodes. You have to select number of nodes where you want to create hole. Say I want to create these 3 holes, 1, 2 and 3. Just click on proceed. define the other parameter. The hole radius approximate 4, number of layers. If I want to create the quad layers in the washer area, then you have to utilize these options. Say I want to use at least 2 layers, same uniform or individual. So I am going to take care of the uniform values, say 0.2 scale factor as compared to the mesh size. Then minimum number of element, at least 16 element I want on the whole face, then click on trim. And look at the magic. Say this hole is created with washer of 2 element. So in this way you are able to create holes. Sometime if some holes are not required, say this hole is not even required for me and I want to fill that hole. So one way is like you have to create geometry, then you have to create element there, then you have to connect those element. Again that will be very lengthy. Just close it. Instead of trim hole, go to the fill hole options. Make sure you are in the utility tab. If it is not available, go with here, view, browser, hypermesh and utility tab. So go to the fill hole options. You have to select the node. Say this node, I am going to proceed now. Then click on fill. Look at very beautifully software managed the meshing and fill the hole. Similarly, you can fill multiple holes. Go to the close and this add washer also I am going to close. Okay, it's a software error, I am going to keep it here. So after the fill hole, the next important option is bead. The box trim is same as trim hole, but here you have to create in form of box. The bead options is very important. Say I am going to perform the natural frequency analysis or model analysis of the system, and the component frequency, minimum natural frequency is not up to the mark. I want to increase the frequency. Of course, optimization techniques are there in which you can optimize the bead shape and size and place. But if I want to add bead as per my experience or as per the available knowledge, available data, I can add the bead. But the problem is that if I want to add the bead here in this component, the geometry is not available. So you cannot modify anything in the geometry. That's why this bead option is available here. So let's say on this particular face, I want to create a bead. Just go to the bead options. You have to select two nodes for the bead. This is my first node, this is my second node, and click on proceed. Define the bead radius, 20 is too much. I am going to define approximate 4, and the bead height. Bead height also I am going to define 4, and the bead shape, sharp or flat. I am going to use the sharp. Just go with the create options and let's see the magic. Okay, bead is created. But the size is very small. I am going to reject it. Increasing bead radius and bead height also. And going to create. Now this bead is created very beautifully, but in the reverse direction. As you can see here, this bead is actually on the opposite face. See? So I am going to reject it again. And defining here the negative value in the bead height. Instead of positive weight, I am going to define here negative weight and click on create. So now the bead will be created in the opposite direction. So in this way you are able to create the bead. Even multiple beads you can create. Even on the curved surface you can create these beads. But you have to make sure at least the fine elements. Because sometime if you want to create a bead on this surface and you have here one hole and only one element on this curvature, then it may be problematic. You have to take care of the fine meshing. So hope you are clear to those important options. Basically, we learn here how to update washer in the quality check, say quality index, and then go to the cleanup tool, and here we have modify washer options. The second options is adding a washer. So here we have add washer options. Just go to the return, and here we have add washer, means I can add washer to the existing hole that don't have washer actually. Then if I have an external hole that I want to fill that is no longer applicable or useful for me, then you can go with here the fill hole options. Similarly, if you want to create some extra holes, then you can utilize the trim holes, and those hole size you can increase and decrease in the quality index. So similarly, you can create a bead also. So hope those options will be very helpful to you. These all options are regardless of the geometry, whether you have geometry, whether you don't have geometry, you can utilize those options. So thank you all. I highly recommend to go with my previous video in which I explained the all options of the quality index and cleanup tool. Those all options. Apart from, I also recommend to go with the HyperMesh playlist if you want to learn HyperMesh very fluently. You want to understand each and every options in deep. I also recommend to you join my Telegram and Facebook group. Link is available in the description. Thank you again.